Hey guys, Theo here, and welcome to the Caffeine Zone, where we discuss everything coffee. And if you didn't know this, then you will learn it now. This is by far my ultimate favorite brewing method to brew. Not necessarily to drink, because you can create so many different flavors that it is really awesome. But I don't want to always drink it, but I always want to brew it. It is really an outstanding method to brew. Of course, our beautiful little Bunsen burner, which we'll get to in a few seconds. And then the siphon. Probably the only method used in today's terms. And when I say today's terms, I literally mean in the everyday life of brewing coffee. That still uses a linen filter. Now, the nice thing about the linen filter is you can get all the oils through without letting any of the particles through. So it's a really clean and smooth and silky cup, yet the mouthfeel can move towards butter or honey or something like that. So it's really, really nice. The downside to this filter is keeping it clean. So unfortunately, you would have to purchase yourself some espresso machine soap. Just drop it in there every now and again and wash it nicely. It becomes beautiful and white again. Obviously, you can see that I have used it twice since the last time I washed it. Now, everybody struggles with this, so I'm gonna show it nice and clear. I've had some of my students go, Theo, how do I use this? Because the coffee keeps on coming down the pipe. And it's because they never sealed it in. Now, if it is your first time using it, don't feel bad. I did it as well before I knew. You just pop it in, take it, pull it down, and hook it up. Now, if the water comes down, it can't lift up. The coffee particles will never come through into your cup. For those of you that struggled, there it is. And of course, your bottom chamber. So bottom chamber, top chamber, and of course, your extraction tube. It's got a rubber on here that seals in here to build pressure, very similar to the moka pot. Now, the siphon coffee brewer. Developed or discovered in the 1830s by Dr. Luff. He was a scientist who worked in his laboratory and ran out of instant coffee, you know, quick coffee, and was like, I need it. I've got some grinded coffee here, but unfortunately we can't brew it. So he built this strange contraption. This is what it looked like originally. So you had the water on the one side and it filtered through these pipes to the other side, and then it would brew the coffee, and once you kill the flame and the pressure goes away, it sucks all the coffee back to this side and then you pour it from there. Of course, the Chinese and the Japanese made it way simpler to travel with. This is not the Hario one. You get the Hario and the Yama. The Yama way cheaper. I would suggest going for this glass. Just as good as Hario glass, but for the Hario, you will be emptying your pocket slightly more. Let's jump into it. I'm going to be weighing out 260 milliliters of water and doing a 1 to 13 ratio. Water temperature, you can go hot water, you can go cold water. This is just normal room temperature. I'm not bothered about the temperature of the water as much, because we're going to be putting a flame to it. So if you use hot water, you'll get to the top a lot faster. In this case, the way I brew it, that's not what you want. Now, there's two different methods, or there's two different ways of brewing this method. First way is putting this down, putting your flame, heating the water. As soon as your water starts boiling, you pop this in, all the water pushes to the top. You put your coffee up top, you let it bloom, you let the coffee sink, give it a stir, and you bring it down to the bottom. That method for me personally heats up the water too much with steam, which means I get too much bitter flavor extracting from the coffee. I prefer to do it the different way. I seal it in. I put my coffee first. 20 grams, as I mentioned. Flatten it out a little bit, not too much, because it doesn't really matter. Open up this flame, and we let the water heat up. Now, you'll see heat waves pulling fairly quick. Now, as soon as the heat waves start pushing, I kind of play with my heat. So I'm gonna bring it down a little bit to create enough heat to heat up the water, but to slowly create pressure. Because I want the water to extract to the top chamber very, very slowly and very subtle. Because I want to give it time to bloom as it wets. Then as soon as I see all the coffee is covered in water and it starts creating that nice bloom effect, I give it some full blast flame to then try and force the water slightly faster. But just before I get all the water to the top, I bring down my heat again because I don't want my water to boil. So there we go. You can see all the coffee is wet. Give it some heat, push it a little bit, but keeping my eye on the water in the bottom. There we go. Now I bring it back down and I just keep my water hot. So you'll see that there's no boiling water down there. Give it about 5 to 10 seconds, kill my flame, give it a good stir, and now I give it some time. Now you can see there's no boiling water. So when the coffee starts extracting back down to the bottom, this is the magic bit, it will happen in a few seconds, you don't have any hot water and the coffee touching. So there's no bitterness happening inside that extraction. Now, some people say it's right. Some people say it's wrong. I think it's just preference. The coffee do taste different though. So try both methods and see which method you prefer. So now we've got all the coffee to settle on the bottom. And as soon as there's enough pressure released as it cools down, you'll see the coffee extracting to the bottom. So check this out. And there's the magic. So the way that this method works is as we heat up the water, you build pressure, very similar to the moka pot. As soon as the pressure is high enough, it forces the water from the bottom chamber to the top chamber, which is the closest oxygen point. It needs to release the pressure. It pushes all the water to the top. Then as you kill your flame and it starts cooling down, it starts sucking back the fluid, because obviously it wants to suck back the air to fill the void in the bottom again. And so it sucks all the water back down to the bottom. And then of course you have your brewed coffee. Now, of course, this thing is hot, so make sure not to burn your hands. Normally we take a cloth. The one time I forgot, grabbed it, and I had a blister on every single finger. So in the meantime, I've discovered easier ways to take this out. And there we have it. Now do be careful, it is glass. If you're not careful, it will break. You're gonna have to replace it. Oh, just look at that. Beautiful, clean cup of coffee. I love it. So 1:13 ratio. And by the way, if you like hot coffee, this is the method for you, because this is slightly harder than most of the brewing methods. So if you had to start drinking that, you would enjoy it. So there you guys have it. I hope you guys enjoyed this. Please give us a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet, and we will see you guys on the next video. May you find your happy place in every single cup.